ozone is O3. Mm-hmm. And when we pass this 100% oxygen through the ozone machine, that's O2 transforming to O3.
Mm-hmm.
But it's only...
And you need like an ozonator to do that.
Yeah.
Right? Take oxygen machine through a machine.
Right. And it only probably we're going to get about 2% of the entire mixture that's actually ozone molecule. The rest is oxygen. So when we mix it with your blood, it's super oxygenating the blood. But then the 2% ozone, depending on our concentration, but a little bit of ozone gas will quickly break down back into oxygen, and in the meantime, produce all these ozonites, these little molecules that have profound immune-boosting properties.
So the O3 converts back into O2, but when it does that, it releases immune-enhancing properties
exactly
into the blood. I've heard ozone is it also has like antiviral or antibacterial properties or something like that.
Powerful. Antiviral, so the entire, you know, any microbe, and then cancer, so powerful. Basically, these.
Yeah, I've heard that people cancer, even combine it with chemo to increase the cytotoxicity of chemo or something like that.
They can handle these, the oxidative stress, whereas the normal cells can handle it. So we're killing them very effectively, and I've seen even the beginning of the COVID pandemic. There's one doctor who sent me a video of a person that just came down with COVID and went through a 10-pass ozone treatment with him. And he showed the testimonial. With each pass, the person had reduction of symptoms. So by the end of 10 passes, the symptoms were gone. Well, she came in with raging headache and was, So it can be very powerful. So we can kill the microbes in the process. But also, it super oxygenates your blood and it activates the antioxidant system in your own body. So not just giving you antioxidants, which have its own drawbacks, but activating your own antioxidant system, that's very powerful.
So is it almost the idea that oxygen or ozone is a pro-oxidant and the response of my cells is to increase their production of antioxidants?
That could be one of the mechanisms. So it also makes the red blood cells more pliable. So they're more flexible, so they can squeeze through blood vessels and deliver oxygen more effectively. There are a lot of benefits that we are utilizing. And
would anybody ever say that ozone is dangerous or harmful? Do you get that sometimes? Because I mean, there's some people who all they know about ozone is the ozone layer or something like that, or we were not supposed to breathe ozone.
Yeah, that's when the debris, that's not the kind of ozone that we're using. So people don't know our antibodies in the body, right? The proteins that's made to attack bacteria, virus, all the pathogens actually can secrete ozone. They can make ozone. So your body actually have the capability of generating
antibodies
ozone.
In your own body can produce O3.
Yes.
Interesting.
Yeah. So it's a naturally occurring substance. So we're just utilizing, again, this is part of regenerative medicine because we're utilizing what's in nature, what can come out of our body to heal our body.
Yeah. Wow. So you do the hydration, and then you took out my blood, and you're going to ozonate the blood that you took out of me.
Yeah,
exactly. And then put that back in me.
Yeah.
Okay. And you do all of this before you do any type of stem cell procedure. Is that because it enhances the efficacy of the stem cells, or is this just stuff you do besides the stem cells to help the body feel better?
Well, just by the fact that it super oxygenates your body, And of course, it's antioxidant capabilities. It helps your body's overall health and helps your immune system to be more active. Active, not in a sense of overstimulating, but boosting it, when it's lowered. So it's basically another way of enhancing your body's reparative mechanism.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I want to, the reason I'm adding all these components is I always say, let's say I can give you stem cell treatment that can produce an effect at 70% of what the maximum possible recovery is. But if I can add ozone therapy that gives you 5 extra percent of of benefit. And I can add the laser therapy that can give you an extra 10%, right? All of a sudden, the benefit is much higher.
You're stacking. And are you primarily treating, because you mentioned, you know, someone in coma, you mentioned cancer. Are you mostly treating people who want to go from good to great, or do you work more with sick people?
I would say 90% of the people who come to us are very sick with all kinds of problems that they have gone through their providers, tried everything else. And so this is because it's not an inexpensive treatment. So they usually try other things first, whatever that's covered by insurance, whatever they can do on their own. But then things were not getting better.
When I walked in here, there was a guy named Eddie. He's still standing in the room right now, but he's on the camera. You probably can't see him. He said he couldn't walk when he came in to see you. But now he obviously can because he's standing there. What'd you do?
So Eddie was given stem cells. Maybe we can just ask him to...
Get in here, Eddie. You're going to be on the podcast. Hit subscribe, leave a ranking, leave a review if you got a little extra time. It means way more than you might think. Thank you so much.